Hi, my name is Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. I provide Mailchimp services such as training, consulting, integrations and so on, so contact me if you need Mailchimp help. Today I'm going to go through how we can add people to our Mailchimp audience. I'll go across to Mailchimp. I'm in my audience at the moment, so all I did was click audience. And I'm in my audience called Gary's Training, which in this case doesn't happen to have anyone in the audience, any contacts. Now, an audience is the place we add contacts in Mailchimp. Some people call it a kind of CRM. So an audience is a singular thing. It's like a bowl. Let's think of fruit, for example. It's a bowl for the fruit, and then we add our fruit, which are our different people, into that bowl. So into an audience, we can have as many contacts as we want. Well, within the plan you're on in Mailchimp, within the limits of the plan you're on in Mailchimp. To add people into an audience, there are actually three ways we can add people. What I'm going to do is just to show you a different view. I'm just going to click View Contacts. And we get this sort of sub-menu up the top here. So I'll just show you. So if we go to Add Contacts, we can add a subscriber, and that's a singular. In other words, if someone calls you on the phone, you can quite simply click add a subscriber, as I've just done. So I clicked add a subscriber, and you can just enter their various information and subscribe them. So that's how easy it is to add a person singly through add contacts, add a subscriber. Now, a very important thing is in Mailchimp, the only mandatory field is the email address. That's the only thing you have to have. You have to have the email address for each contact you add, and the email address has to be unique. So let's say you're a school, for example, and maybe two parents share the same email address. You can't have them as separate entries in the same audience. You can only have the email address once. Okay, so that's how we add people, one by one. Okay, the other way we can add people, and this is pretty cool, is something called integrations. So I'm just going to go across to integrations. Now, an integration is where we connect our other services, our other tools we use, our other software we use, for example, to Mailchimp. So as soon as we add people into other software, they're added into Mailchimp. Just for example, okay, some of my classes, my public classes, I use Eventbrite. So what I've done is I've integrated Eventbrite with Mailchimp. So as soon as someone purchases a place on one of my classes in Eventbrite, they're automatically added into Mailchimp and I can market to them. I use Xero accounting. You might use QuickBooks or anything else, but I happen to use Xero for my accounting. So as soon as I add a customer or a client into Xero, I've integrated with Mailchimp, so they're automatically added into Mailchimp. Maybe you've got an e-commerce store, such as Shopify, such as Magento, such as WooCommerce. As soon as people purchase, they'll be added to Mailchimp and so on. So integrations are awesome. Best of all, integrations are often actually very, very simple, like the Eventbrite one I discussed. It literally is a few clicks, and you can do it yourself even without technical knowledge. You don't need technical knowledge. Some of the integrations you do. So what I did is I clicked on integrations, and you can just search, and you can see their various, of the more common integrations here, Magento 2, UberCart, Volusion, Stripe, etc., etc. Or you can just search for it, Salesforce or whatever, Microsoft Outlook or whatever you use, and you can integrate. Okay, we're not going to cover integration now because that's a very specific sort of topic, and the integration really is specific for what service you're integrating with Mailchimp. So I'm going to go back to my audience. So I've clicked audience. I'm going to click View Contacts again. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show how to import contacts or add contacts from a spreadsheet. Let me go across, and you can see I'm in Google Sheets at the moment. This could be Microsoft Excel, it could be a CSV file. For all intents and purposes, we're going to pretend they're the same, right? So the first import I'm going to do is fairly basic. I have the email address for everyone. Again, that is the mandatory information I have to have for anyone. And I have the first names for some people. Then I will perform another import. And you'll notice I have more people. Some of the people were exactly the same. I've then added some more fields. Are they a repeat customer, for example, and what is their birthday? So it gets a little bit more complicated. So the first one we're going to do, nice and simple. just to let you know is that when we're importing from a CSV file, Microsoft Excel, Google Sheets, etc., it doesn't matter in which order the fields or columns are. So I could have had email address first, for example. It just doesn't matter. So what I'm going to do, because I want to import these people, I'm going to just copy. So I've copied their information from my spreadsheet. I'm going to go across to Mailchimp. So to import those people into this audience, I click Add Contacts, Import Contacts, wait for the screen to load up, and Mailchimp will lead us through a kind of wizard and it'll show us what to do. So are we uploading a CSV or TXT file? No, I'm copying and pasting. So I'm clicking Copy and Paste, and I'll click Continue to Upload. Mailchimp says to me, paste your contact information. So I'm going to paste it in. Don't worry that it looks a bit weird. Mailchimp can handle it, right? I'll click Continue to Organize. The audience I want to add people to, this is if you have more than one audience, but I am importing into Gary's training in this case. Select the status. In a subsequent video, I will go through what these different statuses mean. But for now anyway, subscribe means being able to send them email marketing. Any of these other statuses, you will not be able to send email marketing to them. So I'm going to import them as subscribed. I will go into update my existing contact on the next import. Okay, I'm going to click continue to tag. And I'm going to go in a subsequent video into tags, but you can just add a tag here if you really want to, or create a tag. I'm going to click continue to match. Mailchimp's clever enough to figure out that this is the first name and this is the email address. So that's cool. That's all good. And on the next import, I'll show you how we could change this field if we really wanted to, or one of these fields. And I'll click finalize import. Mailchimp goes through a quick checklist, check that it's all okay, and I'll click complete import. So people will now, or my contacts will now be added to my audience. Mailchimp gives me the option, do I want to send immediately, for example, an email campaign to these people, but I'll just view my imported contacts for now. Wait for this to load up. And there my contacts are. Okay, so this would be called a segment, which I'll go through at a later video. So I'll just click the cross to get out of the segment if you do want to get out the segment. And there my four people are. Nice and easy. Next month comes along. Let's go back to Google Sheets. And it gets a little bit more complicated. So, for example, this person was in my audience. Where are we? Gary plus one. But you'll notice they don't have a first name. But now there's a first name against them. I've got more columns, such as are they a repeat customer? What is their birthday and so on? So let's just go back quickly, jumping a little bit backwards and forwards, but let's go back to Mailchimp and just show you that there's certain default fields we have. So email address is mandatory. We have to have that for every single contact we add. First name we can add, last name we can add, their address, their phone number. On most Mailchimp accounts, except the premium account, we can add up to 30 fields of data. So each one of these, email address, first name, last name, sorry, is considered a field. So we can have up to 30 fields of data. In Mailchimp, and I will, as mentioned, in a subsequent video, cover tags, but you can have an unlimited number of tags as well. The only limit on tags is being that they have to be 100 characters in length. Right, so back to Google Sheets. So let me import these people. Again, all I'm going to do, all I'm going to do with these people is just copy, come back to Mailchimp, and I'm going to go through that wizard again, just like I did last month. Now, there's no need to delete people out of my spreadsheet, even if they've unsubscribed and so on. There's no need to delete them or archive them out of my Mailchimp audience. Mailchimp can handle it. So I'm just going to import. Again, add contacts. Import contacts, and I just follow the wizard. So I'm going to copy and paste, and I'm going to click continue. I'll paste in my various data, and again, it looks a bit weird, but that's fine. Click continue. I'm going to import them to Gary's training. I'm importing them as subscribed, sorry. Now this is important. Update any existing contacts. If any imported contacts are already in your audience, we'll automatically replace the information with the data from your import. This option may make the import process slightly longer. Now, so if you already have people in your audience in Mailchimp and you keep an external source of truth, an Excel spreadsheet, a CRM, whatever, and you import from that every month and import into Mailchimp, you would check update any existing contacts. Okay, and I'll click continue to tag. And as discussed, I won't go through that right now. I'll click continue to match. Mailchimp automatically sees there's my first name, my email address, that's correct. And then it sort of goes into orange. What orange means is there's an error, there's an issue. So let's just say that this were not the first name field. I could quite simply click on the field name, first name, click the down arrow, and sorry, it's not coming up on your screen, but I've actually got a drop down that shows the various fields. So I could choose any field within that. Okay. But for now, repeat. I don't have a field called repeat. So I'm going to click the drop down. Now, what you're not able to see it on my screen at the moment, but what I'm able to do is click something called create a new field. So all I've done, and again, I'm just going to show this, I've clicked repeat. I'm going to click the down arrow, and then you'll be able to see create a new field. And then we can call this field anything we want. For example, repeat customer. You can call it whatever you want. And select the data type. Well, it is text. It's just basic text, the if they're a repeat customer. And I'm going to click confirm. So in the future, that repeat customer field will always be in Mailchimp. Birthday, I haven't used a birthday field in the past, so I'll click it. Again, I'm going to click create a new field, which you can't see, but you'll just click that down arrow, click create a new field. I can call it anything that I want to, but this happens to be their birth date. This is great, you know, having a birth date, for example, if you maybe a restaurant or something like that. Because then what you can do is set up those sort of happy birthday emails, you know, 10 days before the birthday, set up an email saying, you know, your birthday's coming up, book your table at our restaurant. And you would set up those automatic emails in something called customer journeys in Mailchimp, and I have videos on that. But select a data type. This is important. You can select various different types of data types, but in this case, it's a birthday data type. You didn't see the drop down, but you'd unselect the birthday data type and click confirm. So I've set up my various fields. I added these two fields. I'll click finalize import. Everything looks okay. Click complete import. And again, I could create a campaign at this time, but I'll just view my contacts. Wait for this to load up. And you'll notice now that all those people are in here, all those extra people, extra data has been added, whether they're a repeat customer or not, that's been added, that column, the birthday column has been added, and so on. And that's how simple it is. So the important thing to remember is into our audience, email address is mandatory. We can add fields during the import. The three different ways we can get people into our Mailchimp audience is one by one, by clicking add contact, add a subscriber. We can import them from Microsoft Excel, etc. via import contact. And we can go to integrations and integrate our external systems with Mailchimp. And that's how easy it is. Thanks for joining me. Please like this video. My name is Gary from organicweb.com.au.